I would like to call the first speaker of the deputation, Farooq Abbas Chaudhary.
My lord, the move in this house comprises two most important words, crime and humanity. Crime is an act harmful not only to some individual but also to a community and a society. Such acts are forbidden and are punishable by law. And humanity here is symbolizing those innocent Kashmiris who are being victimized for nothing. Being denizen of the Azad part of the Kashmir, I, the daughter of Kashmir, feel the sufferings of my people, an occupied state. Imagine, Mr. President, sir, the people of the former princely state of Jammu and Kashmir are still waiting for the basic right promised to them 7 decades ago. Unending sufferings of Kashmiris are now more than 70 years old. Cradled in the majestic mountains of the Himalayas, Kashmir is the most beautiful place on earth. Snow-packed mountains, slopy peaks, alluring birds on colorful trees, chilling springs and tall trees of Chinar make Kashmir a heaven on earth. But unfortunately, the tale of Kashmir is a tragedy and is the largest and gravest human rights issue facing the world today. Since partition, planned and organized secessionist terrorism has brutalized Kashmir, the valley of peace and exquisite beauty. Systematic efforts have been made to destroy its syncretic culture, heritage and traditions by an orgy of mindless violence, forced by religious fanaticism and extremism, aided and abetted from Indian border. Crimes against humanity in Indian-occupied Kashmir is an ongoing issue. India, the so-called democracy, is engaged in every kind of war crimes denounced by international law. 8,000 Indian forces illegally occupying the territory are committing massive crimes against humanity. And the world is paying no heed to the hues and cries of Kashmiris being mercilessly killed, brutally suppressed, ruthlessly tortured, and barbarously raped by Indian Army. They are being humiliated, their voices chopped. They are being massacred, their bodies disabled. They are being gunned down, their rights trampled. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to remind you, the people of Indian-occupied Kashmir are granted the right of self-determination under the relevant UN resolution of 1949, according to which the question of accession of the state of Jammu and Kashmir to India or Pakistan will be decided through a free plebiscite. But the deployment of Indian troops in the Indian-occupied Kashmir is the largest crime against humanity by India. Indian claim of Kashmir as an integral part of it is indubitably wrong. Kashmir is not an integral part of India and it's never been an integral part of it. The state of Jammu and Kashmir is an unfinished and unresolved agenda of partition. India is merely interested in the land of Kashmir. It has nothing to do with the people of Kashmir. It do not own them, rather kills them, calling terrorists. For Pakistan, Kashmir conflict is not an issue of a piece of land, but is an issue of the basic human rights. The people of Kashmir are the part of people of Pakistan in every way and every form. We are not aggressors, we are the victims of aggression. Mr. President, sir, it is heart-wrenching and traumatic for me to watch videos and news coming from Indian-occupied Kashmir. I remember when Burhan Wani and Manan Wani were killed. I can clearly and really remember Siraj, who got 8 pellet bullets on his face while he's way back from school. I remember Jawad, who got 4 bullets on his chest while saving his sister. I remember youngest pellet victim, merely 18 months old, Hiba Nisar, who was blinded for a lifetime. I remember Shujaat Buhari, who was assassinated while he's way back home. I remember the Pakistani prisoner who was killed in a cold blood in an Indian jail. In January 2019, it was reported that the death toll hits a new peak in Indian-occupied Kashmir. Mr. President, sir, at present, brutality is at its peak in the valley. Torturous detention of lecturer Shabir Ahmed and labourer Nasrullah Khan, strapping of Farooq Ahmed Dar in front of Indian Army Jeep in Badgam, manifests the true picture of world's so-called largest democracy. India is committing crimes against humanity. It is initiating water war through a cutback on the water flowing through its rivers to Pakistan. It do not allow UN observers in the state to masquerade its own brutal face. India is blaming Pakistan as terrorists. My lord, Indian Army has slaughtered UN's Charter of Humanity. Its Article 1 says humans are born free and equal. Article 10 guarantees freedom of movement. Article 11 preserves freedom of speech. Article 12 ensures freedom of thought and expression. Article 13 to 15 ensure food, shelter, and education. India has taken up a 3-pronged war against Pakistan. firstly, by killing our sisters and brothers in Indian-occupied Kashmir. Secondly, cross-border shelling on civilian population in Azad Jammu and Kashmir. And thirdly, by engaging in proxy war by carrying out acts of terrorism in various territories of Pakistan. India is committing massive crimes against humanity. Mr. President, sir, recently an Indian aircraft has violated line of control in routing from Muzaffarabad sector. India will have a severe repercussion for the global peace and security. Mr. President, sir, I wonder whether humans are just those settled in America and England. I wonder whether innocent people are just those living in Europe. I wonder it's only the women who live in London, Paris and New York who are mothers. Is not a Kashmiri a human? Is not a Kashmiri woman a mother? Is not Kashmiri blood sacred? Do Kashmiris not have rights called human rights? Are Kashmiri children of a lesser God? I urge United Nations to fulfill its responsibility to mediate a peaceful resolution of the Kashmir dispute. No matter what happens, the people of Indian occupied Kashmir, young men and women, are signaling their absolute solidarity with Pakistan. They are saying no to Indian rule. They are saying no to Indian crimes against humanity. Brutal India, leave Kashmir. They are saying it loudly and clearly. Their dead bodies wrapped in Pakistani flag. And kids speaking out loud, hum kya chahte hain, azadi, Kashmir banega Pakistan, Pakistan se rishta kya, la ilaha illallah, is a clear testament of the true love for the state and people of Pakistan. India must realize it cannot keep Kashmir as hostage anymore. And Pakistan will continue to extend its moral, political and diplomatic support to legitimate the struggle of the people of Indian-occupied Kashmir. Ladies and gentlemen, I, being daughter of Kashmir, have a strong and faith. The day is not far when people of Kashmir will celebrate freedom, inshallah.